Hello everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to see or to learn how to populate data, a drop-down list to, like, we get data, we populate it with data from the database. We're going to use MySQL, PHP, HTML. Yeah, guys, I hope you have at least a clue about PHP, a clue about HTML, a clue about MySQL. So we're not going to create a database. The database is already there. So we're looking for to fix something like whereby somebody is looking for a tutorial to learn how to populate your data, to pull out data from the database, then inject it into your drop down. So that's gonna help you from using a normal drop down to use a dynamic drop down. So what you're gonna do, you can see this is our database already, this is our table. So if I can select this, I'm gonna get a lot of things which I'm gonna get down here, which we're going to see. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to my, you can see this is my drop down, it has this. I wanna delete this, then I get data from the database. So those, we can see them here. You can see grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, grade what. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna delete all those. Let me close also these things here, close all tabs there, close them. So we wanna focus really on our stuff. We don't want anything which is gonna give us trouble here. What we see here is what we're gonna delete. 1, 2, 3, 4, that's what the also says subjects. So but anyway, we're gonna put something there. Since it says subjects, we can put subjects down and we put grade up because we don't want any other confusion here. So I wonder what happened a bit. Let me see. Let me delete that. And then I saw subject, something subject here. Okay, that's good. Then, oh no, this is something I've been looking for. This is something I've been looking for. We delete subject and say select grade. And what we're gonna do here, simple thing we're gonna do for ourselves, we're gonna delete everything here. We leave only one item. So once we save, this one's gonna be maybe subject. And I think that's fine. We know how to connect to the database, that we're not going to cover that. So press here. You can see the link only have one thing, one item, and also it has a search, which is a smart thing. Then what are we gonna do now? We're gonna go inside the select. You see here, inside the select. Where is that select? Whenever I press OK. Okay, that's good. So you're gonna say get a PHP tag, say PHP, and you open it, you close it. Okay, we need that. No, I'm getting into a wrong thing. This is something wrong. I wonder why this thing is playing me like this. I need this. Okay, you see inside the select, you see this is the select one. So what we do, we come inside here and say, you know, we are avoiding, because we're gonna deal with the loop, we're avoiding the program to loop this. So we go inside here, we want it to loop this only. We don't want to loop this. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna create a PHP section inside here. Then I say yes, section. So I'm gonna select what? Subjects, which are called category in my database. I'm gonna do this and I'm gonna say select whatever I want to name it. You can name it category, or we can say subject. Then you say equals to, you open, then you semicolon there. Inside here you can use double quote or single quote. You say select from, you can select star everything, but we're gonna say from category. So we're gonna go to our table, we see what's the table name and which item do you want to select in there. We want to use this table, and the item we want to select gonna be that. This is the item we're gonna get. So I took table, which is going to be here. We're going to put the table here. We say select from that table. Which item do you want to select here? I'm going to select this. Guys, thanks for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe. We're driving through, we're cruising, but we want you at the meantime. If you can see a subscription buttons, please subscribe. Then we paste also this. Okay, to explain this, this is a query, SQL query. So it's going to tell us that, it tells us like select category from category name. This is category name from category. Then after that, we go down here. We're going to create something else. We're going to say, say subject. Want to make it small. Whatever you say, subject selected equals to con. What is con? Con is the, I stored my database what string in there. It's gonna be con. That's my database. This one, this is the connection to the database. This one you see. Then that's when I'm gonna say prepare. We're using prepare statements. Prepare. Then I go in here, and I come. I store my query here. Get it here. Drop it here. So we're done with this part. This part is gonna deal with that because putting in here. So what we go to another line. We do wanna execute this. We copy this exactly. We put it down here. We're using PDO, guys. Then we say it could not work if you're not using PDO. You must use PDO this to work. So after there, then we say execute. Then we close here. Then we go back here down and we say, what are we gonna say? We're gonna use a while loop. We say while, okay, we open this, we close, but we don't want to close there. We'll pick it down, we'll pick it up and put it somewhere else. For now, let's do that and say, we're gonna say row equals to, we use the same thing, this same, and we say fetch. Use fetch, then we open here, close. Then we say PDO, use double semicolons, then we say fetch asoc, associate array asoc. Okay, we're done with that. Once we're done with that, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna come in here and we say, what do we wanna get here? We're taking this guy, you get me? So we're gonna get this guy and say, we're gonna create a variable here. We're gonna store our stuff. We say equals to a row. So the row, the one we used, the row. Then we get this guy here, close it, then we go inside here, put that, then we do that, then we save. After the saving, so we got this. So since we got that, we're gonna test it if it works. After working, then we're gonna come and choose something else, and we do it in a proper way. We put it in a, gonna say PHP. I'm gonna say this guy, tell this guy to be, this guy to be echoed here, echo, and no, let me do it once. Okay, no problem, we're gonna echo this guy here because it's gonna confuse you if I don't do it once. So we go here, we close that. So we echoing this. So what you do, you're gonna copy this, you're gonna take out this, you cut it. Okay, so that's the end of the loop. So what you do, you put that end of the loop here. We're gonna say we're gonna create our PHP, another PHP tag, PHP. Then we put that, close our loop, then we close our PHP. That should work. We save here. After saving, we're gonna go here and okay, you see, we got them. You can see all of them, they came. all of them from the database, all of them, they are here. You can see how we dealt with these guys. This is so easy, so simple, guys. In case you have any problem or any whatever, you can see try to select all the things. Try to select. In case you have any question, please feel free to ask me or comment in the comment box below. But the tutorial is it has gone well. You can see all of these. Whatever you can search, I'm going to search for transport, I search for construction, I search for web design. So once I search for those, they should come here. Because this is a smart thing. It's gonna say construction. It's there, even two times. We're gonna say police. It's there. We're gonna say grade error. It's there two times. So, guys, thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe. This is one of our best tutorials we made for PHP this year. And I believe we're gonna do more. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. But don't forget to subscribe, and you're gonna get new stuff.